Hi, I'm Joe Saunders with Miniature Landscape Hobbies, and in this episode, I'm going to show you a fast and easy way to paint something that all model builders seem to struggle with. I'm going to show you how to paint windows. Let's get to it. Miniature Landscape Hobbies is proudly supported by these sponsors. As of this recording, there are 218 episodes of Miniature Landscape Hobbies. That's a lot of episodes, and I think a few are due for updates. First among these is going way back to Episode 7, Easy Windows. I want to revisit this, not because it was unpopular, but because it was. This was the first video where I noticed my subscribers and total views taking off, so I guess it was, or likely still is, a hot topic. But in this time, acrylic paint technology has evolved by leaps and bounds, and the method I covered, though still relevant, is likely a little complex compared to what the new paints allow anyone to do now. Why is this the case? Well, in the episode, I basically demonstrate acrylic layering with some wet blends, which is admittedly not that hard, but it can be done even easier now. Flash forward to the present with our absolutely awesome selection of Zenithal paints like Citadel Contrast and Army Painter Speedpaints, and we see a new, much simpler option than wet blends and layering. Please understand that this doesn't make these techniques obsolete. Acrylic layering is still the go-to skill that I recommend all painters learn, but in the case of making miniature windows, in a way that's both fast and good, the Zenithal method can't be beat. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the Zenithal method for making model windows, so you can learn to get similar effects on your own work. This, of course, is simply my approach. There are others out there, and you should likely explore the other options to find a method that suits you. But this one, I find, works well and provides a great trade-off between time and difficulty. What I'm going to show you is also not for display quality work, but it would more than suffice for miniature wargaming and terrain builds. So sit back and relax while I demonstrate my method for speed painting windows. What would be your ultimate bucket list item as a miniature builder or model painter? How about traveling to the miniature gaming capital of the world? For exclusive tours, discussions, and events with some of the top miniature companies in the world, including tours of Warhammer World and the Warlord Games HQ. While we're at it, it would be great to throw in some stops to the UK branch of the Battlefront Miniatures store and visits to other wargaming companies. On top of this, we'll see all the major military and historical sites in the UK, including a visit to the incomparable Bovington Tank Museum. Such a once-in-a-lifetime travel event is no longer just a dream, because from March 7th to March 16th, 2025, I'm inviting you to accompany me on this incredible trip. This one-of-a-kind travel experience designed for the dedicated miniature hobbyist and their spouses or guests is now available for my viewers. Please check the link in the video description. I hope to see you on the trip. Before we dive into the process, we need to look at a little bit of theory. The reason why people dread painting windows and find it so hard is because a transparent object can't be painted. They just can't, because our subject, being a solid, opaque object, simply doesn't have the properties of glass. This means that as a miniature painter, our technique has to be a synthesis of the qualities of transparent material that we can control, and that which the viewer expects to see. There are, of course, workarounds to avoid this, and I've used these tons of time. The first is to imply the glass is missing due to damage or the nature of the construction. This lends itself well to terrain, because we are often modeling a war zone or a structure that just doesn't need windows. Here are ruined buildings for Flames of War. No windows, no problem. The buildings are all destroyed, so it's not a big leap to accept that all the glass has long since been smashed. This rustic shed from my Napoleonic collection also has no windows, or even a door for that matter. But given the period and environment represented, a lack of windows doesn't look out of place. But we often can't justify leaving windows absent. This Apache helicopter is modeled with a closed cockpit, and even if we did make the windows look smashed or missing, the subject wouldn't fit because the model has not crashed. The other common method is to ignore the windows and leave them some neutral color, like gray or black. This is fine for wargaming purposes, but you need to decide what your own artistic threshold is. If your models are going to be used for photography or display, or your tabletop environment is prepared to a higher standard, then the solution probably doesn't suit. With this in mind then, we need a solution. And what we can control to create the illusion of transparency is depth, highlights, and engaging with the viewer to represent glass as they would expect it. Depth and highlights are controlled by our techniques. But when it comes to the viewer, we'll go for the low-hanging fruit. We'll paint our windows blue. The sky is blue, windows reflect the sky, so our windows will be blue. This is a definite oversimplification, but the viewer will subconsciously expect this, so we'll just run with it. Now let's look at our materials. To pull off speed painted windows, you'll need black paint, gray, white, and a blue Zenithal paint. In this case, Magic Blue Speed Paint by Army Painter. I also add Slaughter Red because I'm going to paint a transparent sensor at the same time. And you'll also probably want Speed Paint Medium for thinning, satin, matte, and gloss varnishes, and if you want to line in, a little dish of mineral spirits and enamel panel liner. A broad brush, a dry brushing brush, and a fine brush with a good point are all useful. And lastly, a texture palette would be handy. This list is comprehensive, but don't worry, you can easily substitute other colors or products to get the same result. Now it's time to look at the painting process itself. When you're satisfied with the other aspects of the model you're painting, it's time to start on the windows. In my case, I'm demonstrating on a Swedish helicopter for Team Yankee, though this process would work just as well on terrain or any other type of model you can think of. I start by painting every window black. Go slow here and be neat. It's likely best to thin the black more than usual and to do more than one coat if needed. You want to keep the result very smooth. It's also important that you leave this layer to dry for a good long time because the next couple steps can be quite rough on the undercoat. With everything dry, I now grab medium gray and with a dry brush I fill in the majority of the window by heavily dry brushing everything but the edges of the window frame itself. This lets the black show around the edges. After this is done, I now combine white with my gray in a 50-50 mix, and then I go ahead and dry brush the windows again. I decrease the surface area to allow the black and medium gray layers to show now. Finally, I repeat the process over again with straight white, dry brushing it in an even smaller patch. I do my best to make sure that the white is specifically concentrated to where I would expect the most light to reflect. In this case, near the top of the window frame, and on the most rounded surfaces. After these layers are all dry, I get my magic blue speed paint out and mix it to be about 80% paint to 20% thinner. Now with a large brush, I add the speed paint over the other layers. Because it's thinned, I push and draw the pigment towards the window edges to make the blue deeper in the darker spaces. This takes practice to do, but it isn't that hard. Once the blue is set, the layering over the zenithal base of black, gray, and white gives us the depth we need. So now comes the highlights, which could not be simpler. Grabbing my white again, I take my fine brush and put dots in opposite corners of each window. I try to put them at the steepest point of color transition to make the implied glint of light more dramatic. With this done, the main part is finished, but you really should do some lining in to boost contrast. However, should you want, you can consider this step optional. I give the whole model a spray of satin varnish, which I let dry thoroughly. Then I moisten the model with my little dish of mineral spirits using my broad brush. While the mineral spirits are still moist, I apply the enamel using the provided applicator. I put it in the cracks and crevices, including around the window. I let the satin varnish combine with the mineral spirits do its work, drawing the enamel by capillary action to where it needs to go. The model is pretty much now finished, but since the helicopter is going to be used for photography and as a gaming piece, I gave it two coats of matte varnish to remove the shine and protect my work from the wear and tear of gaming. Before we finish though, we have one last step that's more or less optional. Sure, the matte varnish cuts the shine on the whole model, but I'm sure that you know that glass is shiny. So we restore this quality with a couple thick coats of gloss varnish. And now our windows are done. So there you have it, my technique for doing windows with the zenithal method. I think the results look good, and though they're not quite display quality, they will more than suffice for the tabletop. Best of all, these techniques are far easier and faster than any amount of acrylic blending, so any hobbyist from beginner to advanced can get their models on the table quick and have them look great. Now let's hope that this method stands the test of time, so I won't have to revisit windows again for another 218 episodes. If you'd like to learn about the miniature painting process, please consider watching this video. If you'd rather learn about acrylic layer painting, then consider watching this other video instead. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, but most importantly, please remember to keep building life in miniature.